Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our biology form 2, lesson 19, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on gaseous exchange, under the subtopic, the mechanisms of gaseous exchange in plants. We are going to have the following lesson goals on our lesson, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to explain the mechanism of gaseous exchange in plants. Welcome. So now we are going to look at the gaseous exchange in plants, whereby you can say the process of gaseous exchange in aerial roots, stems and leaf of both aquatic and terrestrial plants is the same. For gaseous exchange to take place, a concentration gradient must exist between the atmospheric air outside and that in the interior of the root, stem or the leaf or the leaves. That is to mean there must be a different concentration of the air. This will permit oxygen to diffuse from the atmospheric air outside where its concentration is high into the plant, where its concentration is kept low due to either utilization by respiration. Similarly, carbon 4 oxide will diffuse out as a metabolic waste product along a concentration gradient into the atmosphere. That is just a brief description of the mechanism of gaseous exchange in plants. So now I would like us to look at the stomata and habitat of plants, because as you are aware, there are different plants inhabit different habitats, and the reason why we are specifically here interested with the stomata is because the stomata is the opening through which gases get into and outside the plant. So now we are going to have a brief description of different habitats. The stomata, they are also modified in a number of ways depending on the habitat into which the plant is growing. For example, we have what we call the xerophytes. These xerophytes, they are adapted to living in dry areas. Often they normally have fewer stomata that are small in size than those of hydrophytes, whereby we can define the hydrophytes as the plants which normally grow in wet areas. The reason why the xerophytes, they have got few stomata than the hydrophytes, is because the xerophytes grow in dry areas, and they try to minimize the level of transpiration and evaporation, that is water loss. So they have very few stomata, such that the water loss is also minimized. These stomata are found mainly on the lower surfaces of leaves. In some xerophytes, the stomata are sunken, and in others they open during the night and tend to close during daytime. This is because at least during night, the rate of sun intensity, it is not very high. So that is to mean there will be very low rate of evaporation, leading to a water retention in the leaves. The partial opening during daytime allows for gaseous exchange. The modifications of mentioned above, however, in water conservation in the tissues of the plant, and at the same time reduce water loss from the plants by evaporation and transpiration. We can have a diagrammatic representation of an hydrophyte leaf, whereby we've said earlier on that the hydrophytes are the plants that grow in the wet areas. So that is, you can see that in the hydrophyte leaf, we have the palisade parenchyma, we also have the scleroid, we have the upper epidermis, we have the pain, that is the fane, sorry, we have the stoma, which in singular is known as the stomata. We have the bundle sheath. At the lower side, we have the lower epidermis. We have the intercellular space, which these are large spaces because at least they grow in places where there is plenty of water. We have the trichomes, and we have the spongy parenchyma. These are hydrophytes. They are aquatic plants or plants growing in water. Some of these aquatic plants are completely submerged. For example, we can have the water lilies, which are completely submerged in water. They have very many stomata that are large in size. Their stomata are mainly found on the upper surface of the leaf. This is because at least even if they lose water to the atmosphere, they can, the root hairs are in a position to absorb some other water, because water is available to them in plenty. The stomata, these stomata allow the hydrophytes to release excess water to the atmosphere. The hydrophytes also have parenchyma tissues with large air spaces to store air for gaseous exchange. We have other plants known as the mesophytes, whereby these are the plants that just grow in the terrestrial areas, or the climate is neither too wet or too hot. So that is, they are just intermediaries there. They have at least some medium stomata. The number of stomata is medium, or it is less compared to those of hydrophytes, and it is more compared to those of the xerophytes. Now, I would like us to look at the structure and the function of the lenticels, cells, whereby these ones are found on the stem. That is, you can see from our diagrammatic representation of our screen, these are openings found on the stems and the roots of some woody plants, and usually they are formed by loosely packed cork cells. The openings permit gaseous exchange to take place between the interior of the plant and the outside by diffusion. The actual gaseous exchange takes place on the moist surface of cells under the lenticels. However, in some aquatic plants such as the mangroves, these are the plants that grow in muddy salt waters on beaches, have specialized breathing aerial roots, whereby the roots are known as the pneumatophores, whereby these are the pores which allow gaseous exchange. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are going to describe the mechanism of gaseous exchange in plants. And to get more of this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Student Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau, or you can get this lesson and more of our biology lessons on our YouTube by sending us an SMS on the number that is appearing on the screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message in our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at @ElimuTV_Kenya. Thank you for watching, and let us subscribe to get more of the lessons. Welcome.